The third case is where the faulting page is not available in the cluster memories at all. In other words, the only copy exists on the disk. So in this case, what has to happen is when we have the page fault on node P for this X, we have to go to the disk to fetch it. And we're going to fetch it, which means that the working set on node P is growing, similar to the first case. And so the local part is going to go up by one. In order to make room for that, I have to necessarily shrink the global part as in the first case. So I'm going to shrink that global part by one. By the way, I can pick any page from the global part. In both in the first case as well as in this case, we can pick any page from the global part and send it out to a peer memory. And that's what we're doing here. So we are saying, here is a page that I have to get rid of. Who do I send it to? Well, I'm going to send it to the guy that happens to have the globally oldest page in the entire cluster. So let's say there is some host R that has the globally oldest page in the entire cluster. And that globally oldest page in the host R could be on the local part or the global part of this host. So what we're going to do is we're going to tell that guy, hey, I'm going to give you a page to hold because this used to be in my global part. I don't have room anymore because my local is increasing by one because of this page fault and adding X to my working set now. So please hold on to this page that I'm going to give you in your global cache. Now this guy has a split like this. So if it has to make room for this new page that is coming in from its peer, clearly it has to get rid of something. Where will it get rid of? Well, it has to throw it on the disk. Now the interesting part is, if the oldest page on host R happens to be in the global cache of R, what can we say about that page Z? Well, it has to be clean because global part is nothing but a paging device. And therefore, if it is here, it must be clean. And therefore, I can discard it without worrying about it. Just simply dump it. Drop it on the floor. That's what I'm going to do. On the other hand, if it is on the local part, it could be dirty. That is, if the oldest page happens to be on host R, and it also happens to be in the local part of host R, it is conceivable that this page has been modified, in which case that modified copy has to be written out to the disk. So in other words, when we pick host R to send this replacement page from my host, this guy, what he's going to do is, he's going to say, I have to get rid of a page in order to make room for this incoming global page because I have the globally oldest page. And if I have the globally oldest page, then let me get rid of it by throwing it out onto the disk if it happens to be dirty. If it happens to be clean, simply drop it on the floor because I know that all the pages are contained on the disk. That's the fundamental assumption we started with, that all the pages of the currently active processes are on the disk. It is just that the global cache of every node is acting as a surrogate for the disk because it can be faster to access from the peer memories than from the disk. So similar to the first case, in this case also, the local portion of the physical memory allocation on host P is going to go up by one and the global portion is going to go down by one. What about host R? Well, it really depends. If the oldest page on host R happens to be in the global cache, then there is no change because I'm trading the old page Z for another page that is coming in from host P, that is Y that is coming in. In that case, there is no change in the allocation between local and global on host R. But on the other hand, if the globally oldest page happens to be from the local part of host R, what that means is that even though originally we thought Z to be part of the working set of host R, clearly the processes that were using it are either no longer active or they've completed or whatever, and therefore we are throwing out this page. The local part is shrinking. If the local part on host R is shrinking, what that means is I can use more of the memory that's available in host R for community service. That's the important message I should get out. That's the important message I want you to get out of looking at this particular page fault scenario.